Most people who catch COVID-19 will experience only mild symptoms and recover quickly, but older people and those with underlying health conditions are more likely to become severely ill, with men at higher risk than women. Professor Martin Michaelis and Dr. Mark Wass are part of a team at the University of Kent working to gain a better understanding of this disease.
We're interested in using the large-scale data that becomes available from the SARS coronavirus 2 outbreak and using that with the other large-scale data that's available about human genes and proteins so that we can try to understand why the virus causes disease, why it differs from other related viruses, and why we see different responses in individuals.
We looked for factors that are differentially expressed between females and males because males are more likely to have severe disease that increase with age or decrease with age because age plays an important role. It's a bit like a puzzle, actually, where you put the pieces together to learn more. And the more people that do that, the more we will all learn together.
Together with colleagues in Frankfurt, Germany, the University of Kent team have identified two possible treatments. The first is called a proteinin and is already licensed in Russia to treat influenza. It's been shown to prevent the virus from entering cells, acting as a viral blockade. The second is omeprazole, normally a drug used to treat heartburn. Early signs show together with a proteinin the antiviral effects of the drug are increased. These drugs are currently undergoing further testing. If they prove to be successful and were made to be readily available, it could change the game in the battle against COVID.
That would make a huge difference because you would have fewer people in intensive care, you would have fewer people on ventilators, and hopefully you would have fewer deaths. And if obviously the ideal solution for the problem is a vaccine, but we don't know whether we will ever have that. But if you have drugs, you can manage the disease much more efficiently.
So, what's next?
We're often thinking of this Agent X or Virus X, this new pathogen that's identified that we haven't encountered previously. And so the more we know about the viruses that we currently encounter, the better prepared we are to treat those viruses and also these viruses that we're not aware of.
If we understand better why viruses cross species barriers and when, and what are the requirements, we will be able to monitor that much better and will hopefully be better in predicting the risk of such spillover events much earlier.